So here we are, day four of Overland Adventure 22 presented by Jeep. And behind me, all of our participants and sponsors are getting ready to hit the trail for our final day of OA. We're going to be leaving Vidal Junction, California, and heading up to Goffs, where we will end our trip. But before then, we're going to hit some amazing wilderness areas, some great trails, and we're even going to sign in at East Mojave Heritage Mailbox number 4. So stay tuned, because this is going to be the last day, but it might just be the best.
It is day 4, last day of Overland Adventure. We're somewhere near Vidal Junction, California, which isn't really that far from Parker, Arizona, close to the Colorado River. We camped in this pretty cool moonscape last night. It was a bit warm when we got here, but it cooled off nicely at night. Had a really fun day yesterday, checking out some of the old desert training center camps. There's more to come today. Supposedly we're gonna travel quite a distance and spend quite a bit of time off-road, which is good.
We've seen so many different types of terrain, different types of weather. We've learned a lot of history, gained a lot of new knowledge about this area, and I'm really looking forward to the last day. It's gonna be a lot of fun.
Yeah, trip's been great. Luckily, no issues with the Jeep. Having a new vehicle out on the trail for the first event, putting in this many miles is a little concerning, but it's been great. The trail's been a lot of fun. It's a good crew that we've got out, and looking forward to some more of it today.
We were able to find out that I'm losing bolts on my beadlock on one of the tires, and that can get really nasty.
The problem is if you lose a bunch in a row like that, then the beadlock ring will sometimes come off the wheel with great force.
I'm removing some bolts from the spare tire so I can do a quick fix and we can get on our way.
So here we are halfway through our final day 4 of Overland Adventure 22 presented by Jeep, and we have made it out to the East Mojave Heritage Trail mailbox number 4 out of 4 on the East Mojave Heritage Trail. Each segment, all 4 segments have a box, as well as the mailbox at the Mojave Road, as well as the mailbox at Goffs. There's 6 in total. Basically, these boxes hold a logbook and establish the amount of traffic on the trail, who came, and we actually have all of those archives back at Goff. So if you came with your uncle or your grandpa back in 1996, we've got that book and we've got your signatures in there. This is part of the East Mojave Heritage Trail, segment 4. We're giving everybody a taste of what it's like, so hopefully they'll come back and they'll explore it on their own. And from here, we're gonna head north. We're gonna go through the Paiutes, see some really incredible scenery. We're gonna pop out of there. We're gonna head to our final patent camp, which is Camp Ibis, and then we're gonna return to Goffs for the final dinner and our goodbyes to all of our friends that we've been on the trail with all week.
We're out here on part of the Eastern Mojave Heritage Trail, I believe. We're at mailbox number 4. Stopped here for lunch, talked to the guy from BLM who has helped us get the permitting to be out here, and he handed out some pins, which was awesome. Yeah, it's been a great day. Really cool trail today, really remote, very beautiful scenes, and it's been a really good day.
It's pretty amazing. I mean, it's pretty inspirational that we can come out here and know that this is box number 4. We haven't seen any of the other boxes, so it's kind of an automatic. You kind of have to come back and hit the rest of them. But it's also a little cool because I like the mysteriousness about this too. Don't share where these locations are so that you actually have to turn it into a bit of an expedition and an exploration to get to them, and it feels a little bit more accomplished by the time you're doing those things. So I don't know, just as Sean said, I think I'm pretty stoked to kind of turn this into a future trip for myself and come hit the rest of these bad boys.
First off, learning about those mailboxes, really unique. And then just to see, you know, when the last person came through here and signed it. You know, it's like a really cool feeling that there's a huge community out there that loves this kind of stuff. And, you know, I'm just happy to be a part of it.
So like building a rig is cool and it's fun to drive around town and everything, but once you get it out in a place like this, this is where they really shine, where all the aftermarket parts really do what they're supposed to do, and you go camping and the shocks and suspension and everything will really perform out here a lot better once you modify them.
Well, Cody has this Bronco that they built on 4x4 garage, and so it's relatively fresh, and I think this is the first time he's had it out on the trail. And sometimes what happens if you have a suspension that's relatively new is it'll flex out and things will accidentally fall out of place. And that's what's happened. This is the front coil spring. It's clearly no longer with the truck. Usually if you notice it pretty quickly, you can back up and kind of shove it back in place and then carefully go forward while it stays where it's supposed to be. He's gone a bit far and his tire's kind of bound up on the bumper, so we're probably gonna use a high lift to lift it up. We might pull the tire off just to help getting the spring back in there, but we shouldn't be at this for more than 15 or 20 minutes.
Yeah,
let's hope.
We should be good.
Hi, I'm Bob Evans, and I brought a 1988 FJ62 to Overland Adventure 22. I call myself cheap. I have a certain budget, so I've tried to fit everything in. I needed a lift kit. All of a sudden, the FJ60 lift kit came up with the Old Man Emu. He gave me mags installed and everything for $1,100. I wanted a rooftop tent, so I kept looking and looking, and somebody that had an FJ60 had the tent, which is on it now, for $1,100. That's how this whole thing's, I look for Craigslist, and whatever I need pops up. Off the back of my vehicle, I have a stainless steel box that has basically cooktop, sink, hot water heater, refrigerator. It's great, I can pull it out. We had a half an hour break today. I made hamburgers and just fold everything back in and take off again. I'm still kind of updating things as I go along. I got the radios in there, put all the lights up, light bars. I'm gonna put a different lift kit on and just get a little bit more clearance. After 5 days of bouncing off the rear bumper, I kind of learned I need about an inch more clearance. I haven't taken this out for 5 days straight, four-wheeling, but it plugged along, was good. The best part were the people. The people are great. Everybody that came and participated was, you know, a lot of fun.
All right, that's it. That's the end of Overland Adventure 22 presented by Jeep. We've made it back to Goffs, California, our original starting point after 350 plus miles of adventuring through the desert. We'd like to thank all of our participants and our sponsors and everybody who supported Overland Adventure, and we hope to see you on the trail soon.